Dear learners, I am Dr. Vinay Supe. Now we will see how pomegranate saplings are planted. After propagation, we have to plant those saplings in the main field. So that's why how we should plant those saplings, that we will see. The best time of planting of pomegranate saplings is in between June to October, because these saplings needs a humid climate and some the temperature should be minimum. So that is the congenial climate required for a better growth. That's why the best time of planting of pomegranate, that is in between June to October. However, before planting, that is in the month of May, that is in summer season, we have to prepare the soil of the main field. The land should be deep plowed during the summer season. Crisscross plowing we have to do before planting. Then after that, proper harrowing and leveling. In some cases, leveling is also one of the important parameter, because the fields are not leveled, and we are installing the drip irrigation in this field. That's why leveling is very much important. The marking should be done in a square or hexagonal system. In both the system, we can plant pomegranate, in square system or in hexagonal system. That depends on the soil conditions and the climatic conditions. But there are two methods. The recommended spacing is 4.5 meter line to line and 3 meter plant to plant. So 4.5 by 3 meters, that is the recommended planting distance of pomegranate. It accommodates about 750 plants per hectare or 300 plants per acre. The row should be north to south direction. It is very important, because we have to get maximum sunlight to each and every plant. That's why if you plant this those rows from north to south, the sunrays from east and sunrays from west, that plant gets properly. The pits of 60 cm wide, 60 cm long and 60 cm deep, 60 by 60 by 60 are to be dug at the recommended spacing during hot summer. All these operations that we have to do during the summer season before rains. The pits are filled with 20 to 25 kg of well decomposed farmer manure. The manure should be well decomposed. We have to add again a single super phosphate, that is the tune of 1 kg per pit, and 20 grams of copper oxychloride and soil mixture, good soil mixture. Install drip irrigation system with two laterals, because the routine method is single lateral with two drippers, but it creates some problem afterwards. That's why instead of single lateral, we should go for two laterals, and that to be preferably inline drippers instead of online drippers. This operation we have to do before planting of the saplings. Saplings should be strictly procured from the government registered nurseries, because the nurseries which are government recognized are verified nurseries. All the planting material is verified, it is disease free. So that's why we should prefer to procure this material from the government registered nurseries. And the planting material should be genuine, disease free and of desired variety. Select well rooted air layers saplings already planted in the poly bags. The air layer should be well rooted, because in sometimes only callus formation is there, so that we should look out that it should be well rooted. Planting should be done in the pits already taken. In summer season, we have already taken the pits, we have filled the pits with the proper soil mixture and everything. So in that we have to plant these saplings. Remove the handful of soil from the center of the pit and plant the sapling. Place the sapling in the soil properly so that no air spaces should remain. After planting, irrigate the plants through drip irrigation. Just after planting, we have to take care of the planting material or the saplings in the field. So, aftercare is also one of the important tasks. Staking is one of the important care that we have to take. Staking to the new plants is must to protect the plants from the high winds. Staking can be done by bamboo stick and tied with sutali or plastic strips. Regular manual weeding should be done underneath the canopy of the plants, because weeds, that is a continuous process, and we have to remove those weeds to minimize the disease incidence. Mulching also helps to control the weeds underneath the canopy. That's why we have to add some organic mulch like sugarcane straw, soybean straw, or otherwise polythene mulch. But the care should be taken while taking the polythene mulch, that the thickness of the polythene mulch, it should not exceed 30 microns. Weeding between the rows can be done with the help of tractor operated implements. As soon as the stem starts growing, some pest problems are there on the stem, like short hole borer or the stem borer. To control all those pests, we have to apply 1% Bordeaux mixture paste on the stem. This 1% Bordeaux mixture paste can be prepared by adding 1 kg of copper sulphate and 1 kg of lime in 10 liters of water. Remove the suckers timely, which occurs on the main stem. That is also a continuous process up to 2 years, that continuously we have to remove the suckers by hand only. Now we will see the important topic, that is training and pruning in pomegranate. Training in pomegranate is very much essential as it is a perennial crop. The life span of pomegranate is about 18 to 20 years. We have to start the training from 100 days of newly planted saplings. The plant should be trained in such a way that it should get maximum air and sunlight for its physiological activities, because these are the natural resources, the sunlight and air. So training should be done in such a way that maximum sunlight should be incorporated in the plant canopy. After planting up to 100 days, the plant should not be trained. The plant should be allowed to grow uninterrupted to have its natural growth. Pomegranate can be trained as single stem or multi stem. There are two methods actually. In single stem, only one single strong and vigorous stem is maintained. Rest of the stems are removed from the ground level. The single stem is allowed to grow up to a height of 1 meter from the ground level. Then it is headed back. This will induce the development of lateral branches to form a strong framework, because we have to build up a strong framework being a perennial crop. Maintain 4 or 5 well distributed branches on all the sides. Care should be taken that the branches should be throughout all the sides. Remove suckers timely, which occurs on the main stem. Now the second system, that is multi-stem. In multi-stem system, 3 to 4 strong and vigorous main stems are maintained from the ground level. Rest of the stems are removed from the ground level. Maintain all the 3 to 4 stems up to a height of 2 meters. The apical portion of each shoot is beheaded at a distance of 2 meter, at a height of 2 meter. It will help to develop the lateral framework. Remove the suckers timely, which occurs on the main stem. It is always better to maintain multi-stem where the problem of stem borer or short hole borer exists, or otherwise for proper canopy management, single stem is better than the multi-stem. Pruning That is another important aspect in pomegranate. Pruning, we do the pruning mainly for the better flowering or better fruiting. Pruning in pomegranate is basically done to stop the apical dominance, that is to stop the nutrient flow towards the apical shoot and divert the flow to rest of the branches for fruiting. The pruning should be done when the plant starts shedding of leaves naturally. This is very important point. Before pruning, the plant should have shed up to 30% leaves. The pruning is to be done 15 days before start of new bahar. When we give first irrigation to the orchard, before that 15 days we have to do this operation. The flowers are born terminally as well as axillary. Therefore, only 20 centimeter apical portion of each branch should be cut. So that is pruning. The pruning should not be heavy. It should be a light pruning. Because the fruitful buds are located at the distal portion of the branches only. Furthermore, removal of suckers, old spurs, dead and diseased branches should be done regularly. The implements used for pruning and the hands of pruner should be well sterilized before operation. To summarize this topic of training and pruning, to utilize the natural resources like sunlight and air, the training and pruning is very much important to get maximum quality yields. Hope you understood this topic of training and pruning in pomegranate. Thank you.